LowRes Wonder Bread.
You must be amazing, because karma has blessed you. At the start of the series, I said that this would be a weekly thing where I would drop off an episode every single Friday and be playing a game, this or that. Obviously, we had the last 2 weeks off. I have some problems. I have spent the past 12 days in a sober house here in Miami, Florida. In the last episode, I let a hooligan, a complete deviant of a human being, Kenny Dorsley. You can't listen to anything this guy tells you, I assure you. He's done terrible things over the course of his life and has no regard for any kind of human being, living or dead. He told me, as a friend, that I need to take either the red pill or the blue pill. And I'm thinking to myself, the color blue? I'm thinking about blue raspberry, blueberries, delicious natural occurring fruits and vegetables. And I made a terrible mistake, and I cannot even remotely blame anyone for that but myself. I should have known better. I have a sordid history with all kinds of substances. And when I took that blue pill, I did not realize that I would then have to take multiple pills following that, because that's just the addict mind. You're constantly looking for a greater high, and that's what I needed. So I went down to South Beach, my old stomping grounds. A lot of you guys don't know this. I spent 17 years on the police force, working the beat for Miami PD. I became an undercover cop, and I started busting drug cults left and right, these sycophants who worship the clonopin. And one day, I got a pretty good score, and I'm thinking to myself, this is an opportunity for me to climb the ranks of the police force. I could be sergeant. So I'm introduced to this fellow, and for legal reasons, I'm being threatened with lawsuits because of that first episode where I name-dropped Mike Ty left and right. I cannot call this fellow John Trump, but I will call him Rocco. Now, Jotron was trying to set up a pretty big deal for me. He had the hottest, and I mean hottest, brown dope that had ever hit the Southeast. And so we go to this Christian biker party out on an island in the bayou. And he's telling me, listen, the guy who's gonna make the deal with you, he's in the back room, we gotta navigate the scene. And I'm just scoping the place out. These people, they make me sick. I couldn't believe my eyes. They were all making communion and blowing lines up their nose. It was a ghastly sight. I look over to my right. There's a gay family in the corner. Everybody's throwing darts at them. I was ready to go over there and bust it up.
Crack some of these knuckleheads.
Jontron, he sees that I'm gonna pull a dart out of the baby's skull, and he says to me, listen, LowRes, you don't have to respect their opinion, but you have to respect their right to voice it. And so, I let go of that dart. And even though I wanted to bite his nose off, I could not jeopardize this transaction. There are greater things at stake than this gay baby. He takes me to the back room. There's this weird looking guy, and I can't tell where the hell his accent is from. He sounds Irish and Canadian. He goes and he walks over to him. This dude with a big horseshoe dome. Jontron starts making a dialogue with the guy. They're talking about something or another, an Iranian. Finally, I've had enough. I step in and I tell him, look, I came here for some coke and 20 cc's of the dirtiest brown heroin to hit the Southeast. This guy, this creepy guy, he steps forward and he's just smirking. He looks like the Crypt Keeper as he does this. He looks like some character out of a Tim Burton movie. He's just,
have you ever considered leaving your parents behind? My family's the only family.
And I didn't know what to say to the guy. I felt a chill. My back, the skin of my back, looked like a raw chicken breast.
he's talking about. Have you looked into what the crime statistics of Germany are?
And I tell him, look, I'm a deal maker. I make deals and I break deals on a daily basis. Are we cutting a deal or what? I got plans. This dude, he snaps his fingers. JonTron brings out a briefcase full of substances. As soon as I got that briefcase, I'm speed walking out of there. I'm jazzercising my ass to the front door. We get back to JonTron's car, he slams the door shut, and everything's relaxed for a moment. Not a word is spoken between either of us. And he turns his head to me, cocks his head, starts grinning. Much like that fellow in the back room. Starting to look like a jack-o'-lantern. He's giving me the willies. He says to me, so what do you think of my friend Stefan Molyneux? I grab him by the lapels, and I say, listen, you son of a bitch. I didn't come here for any of this ideological stuff. I came here for drugs and for wet pussy. And if you don't put your foot on the gas, I'm gonna turn you into that wet pussy. Next time I saw JonTron, we were at his apartment. He was getting spooky. He had blood all over his hands. He was going crazy. I remember he wasn't letting me leave his apartment. We had just done a couple of lines of coke, premium grade. And he's going, I can't let you leave, LowRes. And I'm like, JonTron, you better stop playing these games with me. Something bad's gonna happen unless you let me leave. He's continued to go on and on. He's saying, I can't let you go. So I'm looking around. I look at his table. He's got this box cutter. And so I pick up the box cutter and I go to his throat and I give him just a little nick. And I said, if you don't move out of the way, I'm gonna have to cut you from head to toe. And I'm gonna feed you to my cats. JonTron and I, we don't speak anymore. But what I do with my spare time instead of doing drugs is I play video games. I play video games, and the only thing that I'm hooked on nowadays is these candy hearts. Sweethearts, true love, sour, delicious.
Also, this episode is sponsored by Lubriderm. Lubriderm, that'll get you a fun time. Tonight's game, I might get PTSD, just a fair warning. Tonight's game is Miami Vice. Now, originally, I had planned to play Miami Vice for the Commodore 64. Because I'm thinking to myself, my computer, it can only handle so much. However, as it turns out, I can play PSP games. And this is brand new to me. I've never played anything on the PSP before. I'm going to be playing Miami Vice 2006, which is a really inferior... if you've seen the Miami Vice movie that Michael Mann put out in 2006, it is awful in comparison to the series. Most series, you know, from the 80s, they age, they look like garbage, they're unwatchable. Miami Vice, it is so much more watchable. Colin Farrell's got this mullet, he's got trucker facial hair, nothing like the ever so smooth Don Johnson. And Tubbs is played by Jamie Foxx. Should have waited an extra 10 years on that, if you ask me. So this is what we're gonna be playing. And I am so curious to see what the game entails. Now, before we get started, I gotta warn you guys, I am gonna be playing the game with a Super Nintendo controller, which is not how you're supposed to play PlayStation portable games. We'll see if it affects anything. Okay, we're gonna do either Crockett or Tubbs. I gotta tell you, Tubbs, nothing against Tubbs. You check out Miami Vice, the TV series. And this is not the case with the movie in which this game is based on, but Tubbs on the original series, he was really a sidekick. Miami Vice was advertised as like, it's a buddy cop thing. You tune into Lethal Weapon, Danny Glover is Mel Gibson's equal. But you watch Miami Vice and it's the Sonny Crockett show. Don Johnson is the star, and there's no doubt about it. Tubbs barely even speaks. He's a glorified extra. So, I think we're going to go with Crockett just to stay faithful to the property. Although, if we don't do so well, we're going to go with Tubbs. Look at the best graphics to date.
Yo, Tubbs.
What's up?
That was Castillo. Yeah. You remember Freddy Louise?
Funtime Freddy!
Funtime Freddy? I used to have a friend when I was a kid called Funtime Freddy. He used to take me around to the bushes and, yeah, well, why don't we get to the game? Disable hints. All right, we're just gonna figure this game out as we go along. I'm gonna assume this is gonna be a lot of fun. All right. We're walking. Oh, geez, okay. That's how we shoot, all right. We're crouching. I really dislike the fact that they made Crockett look so white trash in this version. He was really a smooth gentleman. He was getting all the girls. I think he winds up with Bai Ling in the movie. And she is not a treat, I assure you. Oh shit. Alright, let's get in the car. Enter cover. What is this? No. Come on, let's get a move on it. Stop crouching. There's too many cars. Are we in a parking lot? It's really hard to see with these glasses on. Are you in a limousine? Enter cover. Who are we firing at? Who's the bad guy? Keep it moving. We're going around in circles. Is this the point of the game? Somebody firing at me? Oh geez, somebody is firing at me. Come on, fire back. Be a man. Let's do this. Oh geez, what are you doing? Oh god. Oh geez. Reload.
Recalibrate. Re-engage.
Alright, we're moving on. Big fan of Michael Mann. I gotta tell you though, Miami Vice. Well, Miami Vice was really the hot spot for Michael Mann back in the 80s, but his finest work, in my opinion, is Thief and Manhunter. Manhunter especially, but Thief continues the aesthetic. Well, it really began the aesthetic. That was his first feature, I believe. James Caan. Let's kill this fucker. Come on. Shoot him. Oh, jeez. We gotta take these fellas out. He can't aim. Oh, we got problems. What do they say? Blue Lives Matter? I don't think that's the case anymore. Come on. Come on. Oh, jeez. The health bar is dwindling fast. Sonny Crockett? He's supposed to be like this awesome detective, right? This awesome officer of the law. And he's down to 21 bullets here. And his health is going fast. He's fading. These guys are brutes. Absolutely relentless. This is the thing that trips me up. And you see this... Not just in Miami Vice, but tons and tons of movies with any kind of cops. You see gangbangers really holding down the fort and trying to take out an entire squad of police officers. When has that ever worked out in history? Maybe if you're El Chapo, but in the United States of America, it's just not going to happen. You're going to kill 30 police officers and then just leave undetected? I don't think so. In Grand Theft Auto, you would do that, and then all of a sudden, these tanks would start rolling out, and the military would be after you. Special forces. And, you know, you'd be done. How could Grand Theft Auto ever have more efficient law enforcement than the real world? I just don't think it's the case. I think we're going to have to switch over to Tubbs once he dies. Tubbs would not stand for this. Take this guy out. Oh my god. Keep it moving. Crockett can't even run here. He looks like Crockett needs to lay off the Betty Crocker. Come on, take him out. One bullet and you're dead, Crockett. One bullet and you're fired. Oh, we're running out too. Jesus. Come on. What are you doing? Come on, reload. End this guy. He's done. We got two bullets left. This is awful. This is just straight pathetic. We're trying to navigate this course. Sonny, he shouldn't even be on the force. What are you gonna do with two bullets, Sonny? What are you gonna do? Wow. What a little bitch. I think we should quit and we should start from the beginning as Tubbs. Tubbs will probably have his act together. I don't think he'll be nearly as much of a disappointment. We'll play normal again. Here we go, Tubbs. Put me in, coach. Put me in. That's what he was saying the entire time. And we just ignored him. Assume the position. Fun Time Freddy comes out, and we start putting bullets in people. That's what the police do. Making Sonny look like an amateur. Right? You know, you want to know why cops are called pigs? Go out on the town with a couple of them. You'll have a ball, and you'll see some horrible things. I was promoted to lieutenant of the police force. I only laid my badge down after I discovered how deep the corruption ran. How the Molyneux Mafia had sunk its hooks into the police force. And there was really no way we were gonna take them down to begin with. They had sent me on that mission to infiltrate the drug pens of South Beach, so I would die. Because I'm a man who enjoys pure, unfiltered honesty. I don't have much tolerance I can't think of a term right now to describe bullshit, but for just utter nonsense, for lies and deceit. I don't like that one bit. And they knew that I would stop at all costs to take down these drug kingpins who did not deserve an ounce of their power. And that would obviously interfere with their paychecks. Just another pig dying on the job. That's what I would have been. Not like Tubbs here, who's excelling. He's got a you're playing a little too sloppy now. This is really intense, folks. I don't know if you can see this. I'm literally sweating. Oh my god. They're going nuts on me. Take him out, Tubbs. That's actually his nickname. Just take him out, Tubbs. Tubbs is not even really his last name. He was a fat kid in elementary school, and that's just what they used to call him. It stuck. Now he's a handsome man. Oh boy. Oh boy. Come on, Tubbs. End him. Oh god. That was really unfortunate. Looks like this game's a fucking piece of shit. We're gonna do another go with Tubbs because I truly, look, I full on, with all my heart, believe that Tubbs can get past this course. In order to make this an all-inclusive experience, for those feminists out there who are tuning in, just imagine that Rico Tubbs here is actually Rose McGowan, and we're infiltrating the Weinstein Company. Headshot, boom, you're done. Oh, he's back up. We gotta navigate the course now. We got 14 bullets. Come on, Jamie Foxx. Ooh. Boom, took them both out. Let's go collect their bullets. Let's collect our prize. There we go, 7. There's a health pack. We're gonna be back in tip-top shape. All right. Come on, pick it up. Our health is not increasing. Is that supposed to do something? I don't know. All right, we're gonna continue onward. Ooh, we got the weed. I like a game that plays it a little risky, you know? They didn't just give it some kind of generic pharmaceutical name. The weed. The weed times 20. I wonder if you can, I don't wanna be provocative here and turn some people away, but I wonder if you can smoke the weed. Things to think about. We're back outside. Nice palm trees. We're still cutting through here. See, this is a thing I need to pick up. I gotta be reloading before I head out places. Oh, jeez. Tubbs is a madman. He's just going right out there. No concern for any kind of bullets that might be flying back and forth around him. Wild man, that Tubbs. Reminds me of my partner. Old Johnny Suave is what we used to call him. He died in the line of duty. We were trying to raid this crack den out in Wynwood. We had raided this crack den in Wynwood, and he ran right out ahead of me, and he's just firing his gun in the air like he's Yosemite Sam. He's thinking it's the Wild Wild West. And I say to him, Johnny Suave, you need to watch yourself. People aren't gonna respect that kind of abuse of authority around these parts. No, I said that, but I still wasn't anticipating what was about to happen. This maniac just hops right on out from the closet, and he's doing offensive Indian noises. He's going, oh, la, 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 and he's got this little hatchet, and he just goes, right in the Suave's head. Suave has the hatchet buried right in the center of his head. And I'm talking to him, I'm saying to him, you're gonna be okay. You're gonna be okay, kid. But I know the truth. I know he's gonna die. We're in the back of the ambulance. And he says to me, I always had a gay crush on you. And it was at that moment that I had to snuff him out, much like Tony Soprano did to Christopher in one of the later seasons of The Sopranos. He's laying there on the bed, and I give him the old until he passes away. Let's go on in there. Come on. Oh, geez. Oh, geez. Oh, geez. We're close to death. We are so close to death. I can feel the Reaper's fingers gracing my shoulder right now. It's very unpleasant. He's dead. Look, I can't bear to see this man die yet again. This is just pathetic. This is not a game that deserves any kind of disrespect, but it is not a respectable game. I can assure you that. So we're gonna call it quits here. In hindsight, seeing the PSP games run so smoothly, I would have played Vice City, and Vice City's a fun game. Vice City, that would have been an all-time great experience for everybody. You wouldn't have one of these Samus situations where I'm running around in circles for an hour and a half trying to get past one part of the course. He couldn't even make it to level two. And Sonny Crockett, he's an utter failure of a human. We're done with this game. It is not canon, as far as I'm concerned, with the original series or even the awful movie. Next week, we're changing things up. We're still going to be in sunny Miami. But it's going to be a little more of a family-friendly experience. You know, I see the statistics on these videos and on the channel. Odds are likely that if you're watching this right now, you have something between your legs that doesn't look like a clamp. Next week, we're going to do a dating simulator. Oh, yes, Miami Nights, hot times in the city. And we're going to be bringing in my lovely girlfriend, Christine, who's going to offer all kinds of advice, tips, and tricks. We're gonna do that, obviously, and you can sit your girlfriend down beside you as you watch, or your mom, or whoever you have, and it'll probably be a more enjoyable experience, if nothing else. This game was chock full of violence. You know, I'm starting to, you know, pick my ears up to the dialogue going on when they're talking about we gotta outlaw these games. It's a bad influence on kids. This was a terrible influence on me. It put me in a bad mood. I hope you guys cry for me tonight. I am a victim. But I will not let this game victimize me any longer. I'm going to be a strong, powerful man, and next week you're going to see. I'm going to be wooing all the ladies in that game. Miami Nights, hot times in the city. If you enjoyed everything you saw today, please consider hitting the thumbs up button, or if you didn't like it, thumbs down it, leave an angry, mean comment. Look, somebody on Reddit said about my Samus review, what does this ugly guy have to do with Samus? And that's true, that's real. Somebody actually wrote that. Isn't that mean? That's very mean-spirited. But I encourage that kind of dialogue, that kind of discourse, you know? This is the kind of stuff that's really going to improve future episodes. So if you want to sound off below, by all means do that. And what helps the most is if you give me money, which I promise I won't spend on the that sweet brown dust. I'm going to show you all kinds of stuff that nobody wants you to see. Maybe you don't want to see it. I don't know if your soul is ready. I don't know. But that's for a buck. You're going to get some stuff. And I don't know if you're going to like all of it.